Alright guys, in today's video, I will be showing you how to develop a kind of Bitcoin investment website that you are going to really love. It's called the Video Forex Investment Website. In this kind of investment website, you're going to see how you can use this site to trade Forex, trade stock, trade cryptocurrency, and you're going to see that it's almost in a video format, right? You're gonna love this particular script. I don't really know what to say about it until I start displaying this script right for you. And of course, you know that before you get into it, the first thing you need to do is I always advise you to buy a domain name and a hosting for your clients. You can practice on your own domain name and hosting if you already have one, but if you are doing this for a client, you have to purchase a domain name and a hosting. And I always like what Namecheap, like if you know me, you know I like Namecheap a lot. So you always purchase your domain name and hosting from Namecheap if you have a client who gives you this kind of job to do for the client. And all you have to do is just come to hosting and click on shared hosting, right? So you click on shared hosting. When you click on shared hosting, this hosting package is always very good. I love this hosting package. So you say video forex samplesites.com. So you have to just search for the domain name, and if the domain name is available, right? If the domain name is available, they'll tell you that the domain name is available, right? If the domain name is available, they'll tell you that the domain name is available. So you see, it's searching for the domain name, and if it's available, they'll tell you the domain name is available. You see, the domain name is available. All you need to do is just to add the domain name to your cart, right? Add the domain name to your cart, and then you now come to hosting, click on shared hosting, and then you now have to purchase your hosting. So this is the hosting, just click on get started, and then click on get started. So you click on get started, and you just follow the process and purchase the domain name and hosting. So I'm just going to go ahead and create a subdomain, right? I'm going to go ahead and create a subdomain because if I already have a website on this particular domain, so if you already have a website on your own particular domain, you can create a subdomain or you can just create a folder or a directory to get this done, right? But if you purchase this particular hosting for a new client, you do not need to create a subdomain. All you have to do is to just go right to your client manager and upload to public_html. But let me create a subdomain right here. So I want to create a subdomain, so let me just type it here, subdomain. So it's going to load the subdomain, so I'm going to create something like video, I'll create vidfx, vidfx. So it's going to be vidfx.homesolution. So I'm going to just click on this to create it. So let's... All right, that has been created. All right, so you see that has been created, right? So what I'm going to do right now is that this is going to be my URL of my website. But before I assess that, let me just go and create a database. So we will need a database for this, right? So let me create a database. So I just come here again, and so let me just click here to go back to the homepage. Go back to the homepage. So I'm going to type a database. So I'm going to create a database. So I'm going to click on my SQL database wizard. So I'm going to create VDB. I'm going to say VDB. So I'm say VUser. And I'm going to generate password. So I'm going to just copy this password and I'll say I have copied. Then you click on use password. Is that okay? So let me just put this password somewhere so I won't forget it. Okay, let me just put this password right here. So I'll click on create user. All right, so it's going to create a user for me. So I'm going to copy this also because I'm going to need this database and password to finish the database setup. So I'm going to copy that and just put that. And I'm going to click on all privileges. Can you see that? This is very simple. Just follow my step. I'm going to click on next step. Awesome. So the database has been created. So all I need to do now is what? I'm going to upload the database SQL file. SQL means structured query language, right? So I'm going to upload the structured query language file now. So I'll go back to the home page. Then I'll say PHP MyAdmin. Yes, if you want to access your database, you have to click on PHP MyAdmin. So we're going to see the database that we just created. It's called VidFXDB. We're going to see that right away. That VidFX, yeah, VidV, yes. So this is it right now. Can you see that? So this is it right here. So I'll just click on this, right? Yes, that's it. Now. So I'm going to click on, when I click on it, please just ensure you click on it. You see that? Click on it. A lot of people do not know how to do it. You click on it, then you click on what? Import. Then you click on choose file. So let's go to the file. So this is the file. I'm going to give you access to all of these files at the end of this video. So I'll just upload that, then I'll click on go. So it's going to upload my SQL file right away. Yes, you can see that my SQL file has been uploaded right away. So if I click on this database again, you see all my SQL tables, all my database tables we have to show right here. You see all my database table we show right here. Can you see that all of these are my database tables? So we'll come back to this guy first. So let's just go finish what we came here to do. So I'm going to click on this to go back to my home page. Then I'm going to click on file manager. So let me search for file manager. So this is file manager. So I'm going to upload the file now to the file manager, right? I'm going to upload the file right now to the file manager, right? So don't forget, we created a subdomain, right? We created a subdomain called vid, right? So if you are doing this for a client and you purchase your domain name and hosting, you really do not need to create a subdomain. All you have to do is just go to the public underscore HTML, which is just double click on this by this side, right? So this is the public underscore HTML, and you just want to upload, right? You just upload directly to the public underscore HTML. But in this case, I have created a subdomain. This is a subdomain. Can you see that? If you create a subdomain, it's going to appear here. So this is the subdomain that we created, right? So I'm just going to click on upload. I'm going to click on select files. So I'm going to click on choose files, and this is the file. So you see that? I'm going to upload that file. So it's going to take some time, and it's going to just upload that file for us. So let's just allow the file upload, right? So you see it has finished uploading and it has turned to green, right? So it's very important you allow it to finish uploading and let it turn to green. So I've just click on this to go back here. And so this is the file here. I'll just right click on this file and I'll click on extract. So I'm going to what, extract this. So I'm going to extract that. All right, so I'm going to click on close, right? So I'm going to open this folder. Now it's inside this folder. We have to move it back to this VDX or home solution. So I'll just double click to open it up. Yeah, so you see all of these files right here. Can you see that? These are all of the files here, open up here. So I'm going to click on select all. I'm going to click on move. Then I am going to just remove this VD and click on move files. All right, so you see that all the files have been moved to VDX. Can you see that? All the files have been moved to VDX. So let's just see, let's test. So let's just put this on this browser right here and see. So just put it on this browser right here and see. Awesome. Can you see that? Awesome. Can you see that? Awesome. Can you see that? Can you see that? Oh, awesome. Awesome. Can you see that?
Your investment up to 95%. We provide you wide range of trading instruments and assets, as well as excellent 24/7 live support service.
I can just remove this YouTube video on top. Can you see the video chat? Can you see that? Can you see that? Automated video chat. Wow. It is beautiful. This is awesome. It's automated video chat. Can you see that? I can even change the lady I'm chatting to. So you have Monica here. We can change to Kathleen. You see, it's going to change to Kathleen. Can you see Kathleen? Can you see that? You see how it's moving. Can you see that this is a very, very powerful script. Very, very powerful script. Can you see all of that? Can you see that? Very powerful script. Can you see that? I can click on here and see these people who are online. Can you see that? So they have up to 5 of them, right? Can you see that? So let me see. Click on watch this. So let's click on this.
How to start? First, choose an asset you want to trade out of all available groups. Enter the amount of current asset you would like to buy or sell. You will always see the available leverage and the required balance for opening this.
Let me play that again.
How to start? First, choose an asset you want to trade out of all available groups. Enter the amount of current asset you would like to buy or sell. You will always see the available leverage and the required balance for opening this exact order.
You see that?
Click the place order button to set the goal or
include the other one.
How to start? First, choose the asset you want to trade out of all available groups.
Yes, can you see that? This is exactly the same way this script works. We'll get into it soon.
You can see your potential payout next to each asset before you place an order. Choose an option type and the exact expiration time.
Now get into all of these different scripts so you're going to see that.
You do have an opportunity to join an option at any time before the purchase deadline. It is marked with an orange line on the chart. Or set the full length option by yourself. Fixed time button.
So let me just pause that and let me remove that. So you can see this is coupling. They are about 4. When they are all online, it's going to show right here. You see that? See this? So awesome. Can you see the script? Can you see that this is so beautiful. Can you see that? This is so beautiful. So the next thing we want to do is we are going to configure the login and the sign up, right? We're going to configure the login and the sign up. So don't forget we have uploaded our database information, right? We have uploaded our database information. So we're just going to configure the admin. We're going to configure the login, sign up, and the admin right away. Let's do that right away. So let's go back here and let's go to... So you see a file here called the con.php, right? Con.php. So you right click on this file, then you click on edit. So let's edit that file. Awesome. So you click on edit. So you're going to see the DB username. You're going to see the DB password. You're going to see the database. So we are just going to replace them all with this information. So this is our password. So let's just copy our password right away. Let's just copy our password. And then this is the password. From here to here is the password. Can you see that? So I'm just going to put that right there. And let us copy the DB username. So this is the DB username. So copy the DB username. Copy the DB username. This is the DB username. Just put DB username here, and I'm gonna pull the database here. So this is the database. So you're gonna put the database here. So this is it. So just put this here. Yeah, so just click on save changes, right? So save changes. So let's go back right here, right? So we're also going to see inside what we call your admin. This is the admin. I'll take us to the admin area. Let's open it up, double click on it to open it up. So let's look for the con file. So we also have the con PHP, we also have the DB con PHP. So let us see the con. So let's see the con. Where is the con? So you right click on it again and you click on edit. Awesome. So no need to just do that again. Just come to the first one that you did. Select or just copy and copy them and use it to replace everything you have here. Then you just save that and close that. Then you come down, you see the DB con. Right click, then click on edit. and you just do what? You just paste that and you're gonna save changes and you let go, right? So let's reload the server. So we have configured the admin. So let's go back one more step. So let's go back to VDX. So let's go back to dashboard. Yes, there's a folder here called dashboard. So double click on dashboard to open it. Then you're also going to see the con, right? So you're going to see the con here. So let's also right click. These are the database connections that we must connect to get this site working perfectly. So I'm just going to copy and paste again, and then I'm going to save all of that. Awesome. So we've copied and pasted and we've saved all of that, and let's just refresh. Awesome. So if we click on login right away from here, you're going to see that. So you see that our login is working, right? Can you see that? Register here. Can you see our registration is working? Can you see all of that here? Yes, our login is working, our registration is working. Then let me show you how to go to the back end, which is the admin end. So just copy this and let us put this one here. Then you say your admin. So your admin, right? This is going to take you to the back end. Can you see that? So the username is young and the password is young. So let me just put a username in case you want to check out this yourself. Username is young and the password is young. Can you see that? Username is young and the password is young, right? So we're going to log into that very shortly. But let's just come here first and see how this works. But before we see how this works, let's go back to this site, and you can change everything you want to change in this site, right? You can change everything you want to change in this site. You can change everything. You can even remove these videos. Yes, you can remove these videos if you want to remove them. You can remove them. You can change all of this information you have right here. You can change everything that you have in this place. You can change the logo. So if I just right click here and say copy image address, so I'm going to put this right here. So if I press enter, so you see that the logo is inside VDS Home Solutions /tools/assets/img/inner. So /assets/img/inner, and the logo is logo.svg. Right, so if you are creating your logo, make sure your logo is .svg to just replace that automatically. So let me show you inside assets. Let's go back here. So let's go to VDS back here. So yeah, then inside assets, this is assets, this is img, then inner. Look at it here. All right, so you can see that. So see the logo.svg. So I'm not going to be showing you how to create a logo.svg. So you can just look for an application to create a .svg file, or you give it graphics designer to just create a logo for you .svg file, and you just upload right here, and you are going to replace the logo right here, right? See that? I'm going to replace the logo right here. Even on the admin that back end, this logo here, if I click on copy image address, if I put it right here, the image address, and this is png. So you see that you're going to go to vdsfhomesolution.com/your-admin/images/logo. So I'm also going to show you that here. Let's go back here. So it's going to be your admin. Look at it here, your admin, yeah, images, and you're going to see the logo will be right here. Can you see that logo.png? So you just create exactly that name. Make sure your logo name carries that same particular name, right? Make sure your logo name carries logo.png, and you just upload to replace that file. Let me just save it somewhere here. It's a document. So it's logo. Can you see that logo? So if I save it inside document, so if I want to upload, if I want to replace it now, I just go back here. Just go back here. Ready? I go back here. You see that I go to VDS. I go to VDFS, then I go to what? Your admin, can you see that? Then I'll go to what? Images. Then I'm going to upload this. Then I'm going to select files, choose files, and then it's inside documents, and it's called logo. See that? So it's going to replace what I already have. Can you see that? So that's why you need to just save it with the same name. So that will just replace. It will just replace and give you your beautiful logo to show right here, and your beautiful logo to show right here. Can you see all of this? This is so fun. So now let me show you how to easily edit this, in case you want to edit this, let's say you are using another name and all of that, but you don't really need to do a lot of work on this. This is so powerful. This is a very powerful script. It's a very, very, very powerful script. Can you see all of that? So let's say you want to edit any of the things. So you just go to the index file. So let's go back right here. So let me just close this, guys. Close this, guys. And closing that. Okay, this is the file manager. So let's go back here. Yes, so when you scroll down, so this is the index file, right? So this is the index file. Can you see this index file? When you click on the logo, it redirects to this file. So this the en.html and this index file, they are the same file. So anything you do here, make sure it's the same thing here. So I just right click on this, then I'll click on edit. Right, so it's going to open that up for me. Can you see that? So you see this video effects part. So if I'm, let's say I want to replace that, I just come here, copy that, and I'll just say Control F. Then I'll paste this here. Can you see that video effects? Can you see that video effects? So anything you want to write, say tutorial video effects, video forex. Can you see that? So you see, I've stopped under these stops under the side. Let's say this financial provided by blah 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 blah, chosen and committed trust for the company. So all of these files, all of these, you see them, even this Instagram and these, you're going to see all of them right here under here. So you're just going to look for all of them and you're going to save changes. The good thing about this script is that you don't really need to do much because everything has been done for you. Can you see that? Everything has been done for you. Awesome. Oh, this is so, so awesome. This is so, so awesome. I really love this. It's so, so awesome. Video cryptocurrency trading website. Can you see that? It's so, so good. I really love this. So, okay, now let's go ahead and then sign up. But before we sign up, we need to configure everything so that we can be getting email when somebody sign up, you know, when somebody make transaction and all of that. So we need to just configure it, right? We need to configure everything. So let's go to the sign up file. So if I click on sign up here, so the sign up file is what, the register, en/register.php. So let's go look for that file. So let me just close this. So I'll go back here and I'll go to the en. Can you see that en? Then I'm going to look for the register file. So it's going to be register.php. Can you see that? So I just right click it. I'm going to edit that. So I right click it. I'm going to edit that. So you can see all of the information right here. So I'm just going to look for the email configuration, right? So you can see a link here to verify. So you, all you have to do is make sure you change and remove this particular link here and put your link. So this is the link to our website. So this is the link to our website. So just copy this and come right here and then change this to this. Can you see that? Some things are here, verify. So you have to change all link that is not yours, change them to your link. So let me just scroll down one more time. Just check the codes. So everything you want to change. So you see the HYIP email information right here. See the email for Forex FS account setup, so you can change it to whatever you want to change it. But I'm just going to change this email. So let's go back right here and create our email. So I'm just going to create, go to email. Click on email account. So let's create an email we want to use so that we can get mails delivered to and from when anybody does anything. So I'm just going to select this subdomain, which is this. So I'm going to say FX, right? I'm going to say FX, right? Then I'm going to generate. So anything you like can be info at. I can even create info. You know, anything you like can be info. So generate, and I'm going to create this. So my this is info, right? Info at. So where is it? Info, okay, look at it here. This is here, info at. So this is here. So I'll just copy this. So this is the mail I want to use for all my configurations. So when I come here, I just change this email to this email. So when people sign up, I can get a mail. This email will automatically send a mail. So come here again and change this email to this particular email. So put it right here. And I think that's that for that, right? So this is the title, what shows on the title, anything you like, you can just put right there in the title. So you just look at all of these codes. So everything is very, 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 very simple to do, right? So I think that's all I need to do right here. That's all I need to do right here. So I'm just going to save these changes. So let's look at another file called the login file. So let's look at the login file. So the login will be login.php. So let's just see what the file is. So let's come here and click on login. So it's login.php. So let's go look for the login.php. Login.php. So this is the login.php. Then you click on edit. You just right click and you click on edit, right? So just also check to see that. So he said we redirect you. So when you register, you see say access granted. All right, let's see. So you see it's also this please register redirect you. Yes, that's when you register. I'm gonna show you something like this. Access granted. Access granted. Look at it. Access granted. Access granted. Please wait. It's going to direct you in a moment. Can you see that? It's going to direct you in a moment. So it's going to direct you to this dashboard, and then all right. So let me scroll down. I'm going to see if also. So it's also see this link right here. Can you see that? This link right here. We have to change this link right here to our link. So let me just put all of this information that I need here. So put this information that I need here. So let me just go back here and copy this and come here, right? So I'm gonna. Replace this with this, yes. So you have to just look for 2020, so you have to change it to 2021. So it's showing providers, you have to map video forex. You have to take your time to do all of this. This is a job that when you want to do, you can charge up to 500k, 300k to do. You don't expect not to just do any work at all. So let me just copy this email right here, and I'm going to replace with this email. I'm going to replace with this email, and I'm going to replace with this email. So yes, can you see that? So I'm going to replace that, and I'm just going to do what save that changing. Now another very important file that I really like to edit here is when you make a withdrawal on this site, you know, a code, a verification code for withdrawal will be sent, right? A verification code for withdrawal will be sent. So I like to edit that file also to make sure the email confirmation will work very well on that side. So let me go back to vid.fs home, and I'm going to dashboard. That file is withdrawal.php. Withdrawal.php. I think it's user withdrawal.php. So let me click on edit. And this is the file. This is withdrawal.php, right? Withdrawal statement has been initiated successfully. Yes, so then you see a progress bar, then verify withdrawal. Yes, so I'm just going to come down and look for the email configuration setting right there. It's an email configuration setting. Yeah, this is the email configuration setting right here. So I'm just going to replace this, and I'm going to just put out here, and I'm also going to put it right here. Can you see that? So just look for anything that you know. You see this guy here is showing providers option account withdrawal. So I'll put my site name, video forex, right? So I'm gonna put my site name, video forex, and all of that. So so that's that for that. So all I need to do is just what I'm just gonna do, what I'm gonna save that right in. So let's just go back to our website and do a refresh. So let's just do a refresh. So let me come to the home page. All right, so I'm here at the home page. So let me just sign up. So I'm gonna sign up. So I'm gonna enter my full name. Enter my full name, then I'm gonna enter my Gmail. So I'm gonna enter my password. So I confirm, then I go to click on register. Awesome, can you see that? Registration successful. We have sent an email to your registration system. We direct it to your account and enjoy trading. Can you see that? So my registration was successful. So system is going to direct me. Can you see that? So system has redirected me. Can you see that? Awesome. Wow, can you see that? System has redirected me. Wow, this is so awesome.
This is so awesome. Can you see that? So you see the call and the put that stuff video was trying to explain the other time. So system has redirected me. So you can trade in Forex, you can trade in crypto, right? You can trade in stock. Can you see that? So you can click on any of these. You see it's going to show you your trade view. All right, so can you see that? So and you can see the trouble, you know, the call and the pull there. So the first thing we're going to do right here is that when we register, is we must fund our account. So you just go to account, then you go to fund account. So you go to fund account. So you can see this script has Bitcoin, it has Litecoin, can you see that? It has Western Union, it has MoneyGram, it has Ethereum, it has bank transfer, it has Tron, it has Chip Cash, it has PayPal, it has Bitcoin Cash. So I'm going to show you how you can change all of this. For instance, this Bitcoin, how you can change this Bitcoin address to your address. So let's say, let me put, $3,500. That's what I want to deposit. So I click on fund account. Can you see that? Can you see that? Awesome. Amount based 3,000. Once payment is completed, received should be sent to support Adil. So you see that, and the it's going to be on funding process of PHP. So on funding process of PHP, you can change this wallet address. You can change this email to your own. So let's go to dashboard like funding process of PHP, and let's just see that too. Let's go to let me just remove this. So I go back here. I'll go to dashboard. Now go to fund the process. Fund the process of PHP. So let's look for fund. Look at it. Fund the process of PHP. So I'm going to click on edit this, right? So I'm going to click on edit that. So let's just see. Let's search for this support, and you see we're going to see that email right here. So Control F. And put this support. So you're gonna see that. Can you see that? Once payment is complete, what you are seeing there is here. So you're just gonna change that to your own email, right? You're gonna change that to your own email. So I'm gonna change that to my own email. So you just change that to your own email, right? You change that to your own email. So that's how you change it for all of them. So you can see the Bitcoin wallet right here. Look at the Bitcoin wallet. This is the Bitcoin wallet. Can you see that? The Bitcoin wallet official. Bitcoin wallet that you see. So let me show you the Bitcoin wallet. Let's first of all save this. So let's come back here. This is the Bitcoin wallet. So let's just copy the Bitcoin wallet. So copy wallet, and let's come back here. And if we search for that particular wallet, that wallet is going to appear right here. Can you see that? So I can just change that wallet to my wallet. So this is the wallet. I'm going to change that wallet to my wallet right away. So you can see that. So that wallet has been changed to my wallet, and you can see this QR code image. Can you see that? If I copy this QR, this link here, and let me just paste it on my browser so you see what I'm talking about. If I paste this on my browser right here, can you see that? If I paste this on my browser, so you can see that it will just change pre-add this information, which is the same information you are seeing here right here. So if you want to change that, you want to change that to your own. So you just make sure you create, if it's from Luno, you can get this, or from your blockchain, you can also get this. Or if you don't need it, you can just go right away and delete that from that, right? So just save changes of what we have done. And let's come back here and try to refresh this. So let's try to refresh this. So you can see the wallet has changed, right? Can you see that the wallet has changed? So this email, let's change this email. I think we have this email in many occasions right there. So put this. So it's going to bring out that email again. Can you see that? So we have to change that. Paste it. The email is just there for all of the wallets. Paste it. Press enter again. It's going to appear right here again. And change it, right? So you're just going to change anything, that email, any email that is not yours, you have to change it to your. Oh, I'm no wonder I'm pasting back the email, right? So I'm pasting back the email. That's why that email. So you just change all of these to your email. That's what I'm trying to explain, right? You see, I'm pasting back this email. That's what that email is showing. So just change all of these emails. So the same thing when you come to Litecoin. When you come to Litecoin, Litecoin wallet address. Can you see that? You see the Litecoin wallet address and all of that. All of the addresses that are here, you can change them from what fundingprocess.php, right? So so now let's say, okay, these funds have been deposited, right? So it's now time for us to log into the admin. So this is the admin link. Let me just open it in another browser. So this is the admin link. So we are going to see that user, and we are going to see how much that user has deposited. So I told you the username is Young, small letter Young, and the password is also what, small letter Young. So I'm just going to sign in. You see that authenticated? Wow, authenticated. So I'm going to sign in. Also, can you see that? Look at the name and look at my deposit, and you can see it's pending. Can you see that? It's pending. Can you see that? This is my deposit and it's pending. So if I go to register user, I'm going to see user that I've registered. Can you see that activated? And you can just click on this to approve this particular user. Can you see that this particular user is approved, right? So you can go to user deposit again. So you go to user deposit, you click on this, and then you see that from pending, you click on approve. This will be approved. You see that you are going to do all of this manually. That's one good thing about this script. The transaction was successful. Can you see that? So if we go back right here to the user wallet, so let's go back to trading account. Let's go back to trading account, and let's go back to funding account. So you see that if you come back here, you see that we have 3,500 euro right there. Can you see that? And if we go to accounts, go to settings, we go to security settings, we see because we just approved the account. Let's go to security settings. Because we approved the account, you see that let's click on security settings, personal settings. Can you see that account is verified because we approve the account, right? Because we approve the account, you can see that the account is what verified, right? So you can see that the account is verified. So now let's go back to trading again. Awesome. So let's go back to trading, and then we'll come back to trading since we already have the 3,500 euros in our account. So the next thing is we want to now trade, right? So we want to now trade now. So let's trade. So I click on the intraday. I click on expiration, so I say let it expire in 4 minutes, and I want to trade 3,500 euros. So I'm going to put 3,500 euros. So can you see that if I trade 3,500 euros, I'm going to make 3,168 euros in addition to the 3,500 euros. That's about 7,168 euros, right? So I will click on put right here. So you see that mainly I click on put. So you see, wait, can you see that trading successfully, please? Can you see that everything here you can control from the admin? So let's go back to the admin and see how to manipulate that. So let's go back to the home from the admin. Go back to the home from the admin. So you can see this is confirmed. Then let's go to trade result. Trade result. Can you see how much was placed there? 3,500. Can you see that? So 3,500. I see the percentage, which is about 90.5%. So I'm going to click on this right here. So if I click on this right here, you see that when I click on that, that is just going to bring this up. So profit any, I cannot say 3,168 dollars. Can you see that any profit? So this is 3,168. Can you see that? So that was what it was telling us. That's going to be a profit. 3,168. Yeah, 3,168. 3,168. Can you see that? So you leave this like this, and you just come here, and you say successful. And you click on the word. So you can say traded successfully. Then you have to now post. So just watch what's going to happen. So profit posted successfully. So now let's go back to our account. You see admin is in total control of everything. Can you see that admin has a total control of how much the user is making and how much the user is losing? So let's go back to our trading account. So if we come back to our trading account, let's refresh this and come back to our, so can you see that this person has made 3,168. Can you see that? So let's go and double it again and see what's going to happen again. So let's go and double it. So let's just add let's add another profit. So we're going to add is $3,500 invested, $3,500. Can you see that? And say successful. So traded successfully. Let's post this again. Yeah, I've added that again. So you're going to see what's going to happen again. So let's come in and refresh this again and refresh that again. Can you see that? He has made $6,668. Can you see that? Can you see that? This is so, so powerful. So from the admin end, you can invariably control the trading, right? You can invariably control the trading, you can control the call, you can control the put, right? You can control every single thing right here. And so users can, let's say, go to transaction history. So you can see account funding of 3,500 was successful. If you go to trading history, you see that 3,500 successful trade. Can you see that? So if I go to any history, so you see the any history, 3,168 and 3,500 any history. Can you see that? So if I go to withdraw, so let's go to account, let's go to withdraw. Let's go to withdraw. So right now we're going to withdraw. So 6,668. Let's say this guy wants to withdraw. Let's say he wants to withdraw just $2,500 from his account. So when you click on withdraw and come here, you say I have a Bitcoin account. So you have to put, let's say you want to withdraw $2,500. You have to put your Bitcoin wallet. So that's my Bitcoin wallet. So I click on next. Can you see that your withdrawal statement has been initiated? Can you see that? So if I withdraw $2,500, this is not going to be what is going to be left for the account. So can you see that? It's counting. Can you see that? Just watch what's going to happen. This is a very, very powerful script. A very, very powerful script. Very powerful script. Very powerful script. Very powerful script. So please wait. So you see redirecting. Can you see that? Redirecting. You see that? Awesome. Can you see that? Withdrawal confirmation code is needed to complete your transaction, right? So if this is successful, it's just going to send you a mail. So let's see if an email was sent to that particular email that we use in registering that account. So let's just check if we will get that email on that account. Can you see that? Withdraw account confirmation. Can you see our successful registration? Can you see that? So let's click on withdraw account confirmation. Can you see that? Withdraw account confirmation. And this is the email right here. Can you see that? This is the email, right? This is the code right here. So we just copy this code. And if you still go to admin, let me show you something. If you go to withdraw, if you still go to admin, go to withdraw. So let's go to withdraw. You are still going to see that same code. Look at the same code here. Can you see that? Look at the person's Bitcoin. And look at this amount of the remaining from his account. And this is the amount that he's requesting. Can you see that? So let's just enter the code so that we can complete the process. Let's just enter the code and complete the process. So I come here now and I enter the code and I click on confirm. So see what's going to happen. Awesome. Can you see that? Your withdrawal request is successful. It will reflect in the next few minutes. Thank you. Can you see that? So admin will also need to work to approve that withdrawal. Can you see that? Everything is done. You see that processing. Can you see that? If admin approve it, so admin is going to approve that. 2,500. Can you see that? Admin is going to approve that. I click on what? Approve. Can you see that? That withdrawal has been what? Approved. Can you see that? Confirmed. The withdrawal has been confirmed. So when the user go to his withdrawal, you see that 2,500 has been deducted from this account. Wow. This is a very, very robust and very, very powerful, 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 powerful system. So let's go back here to the homepage. Let me just quickly show you something. So you can even say, okay, probably you don't need this robot. You can say, okay, you don't need this robot, this all of this video here. You can even remove them, this robot and everything that you see right here. You can remove them from this. Let me just show you how you can remove them. So you just go to the it's on the index file. So let's go back to here. So let's go back to here and let's go back to the index file. So if you go back to the index file, let's just say, let's control F, let's say YouTube. Yes, so you can actually remove. Let me just type broadcast here. Yes, so this is it. Yes, you have typed broadcast here. Look at it here. So this is it right here. This is it right here. And the robot is controlled by this particular site, this rocketscript.php broadcasting. Can you see that the robot is actually controlled from this particular place? And here there's a link there to register. All you need to do, just remove that link here, put your site link, right? So you put your site link. So you have to just take time to look into the script very well. So you put your site script right there. Yes, you put your site script right here. Can you see that? So if, let's say, I want to remove, I don't want the robot. I don't want those robot 3D and all of that. So I can just cut this one off. Can you see that? Let me save these changes. And let me just show you what I'm trying to say. So let me refresh this site. You see the robot will no longer be, can you see that? The trading, the robot and the customer care video chat will no longer be here. Can you see that? So you can invariably do anything you want to do with this script. The codes are very clean and very easy to edit. So I'm just going to put that back right here, and I'm going to save this right here. Awesome. Can you see that? So you can just do that any way you want it to be done. There's something again I want to show you. Let's go back to settings and go back to personal settings. So when you go back to personal settings, you also see that this particular link, right? Can you see that this particular link is not your link, right? It's not your link of your domain. So you just go to personaldata.php. Let's go to dashboard and personaldata.php. We'll be able to work on that. So let's go to VDS and then to dashboard. Then we'll go to personaldata.php. So let's look for the personaldata.php page. Yes, so I just right click this and I click on edit. So when I say Control F and I search for this referring, can you see that? This is your referring, can you see that? So this is the link that is showing there. So all you have to do is just remove everything that you have here and then put your own link there. So this is the link to our website. So I'm just going to come back here and just replace that. Can you see that? I'm just going to replace that with that link. Then I'm going to save that. So if we go back right here, where is it? If we go back right here and refresh this, we are just going to see that the link has changed. Can you see that the link has changed to our referral link? This is a very, very robust and a very, very powerful video forex trading system that you can manually change and control the profit, the lose, and the trading, right? So thank you so much for listening to me, and I'm going to give you access to this script right now, right? So if I want to put a price tag for you to get this script, I'm not going to charge you less than 100,000 naira, because if you want to do a site like this for somebody and you charge 500,000 naira, I can assure you they are going to rush this. In fact, it's the best, and the mobile is very, very good. You can try it on mobile. You see, it's excellent, right? It's excellent. So what I'm going to do is that I'm just going to charge you 30,000 naira. If you live in Nigeria, you're going to pay 30,000 naira, and I'll give you access to the script and this video. All you need to do is just configure this script and start using it right away. Can you see the chat? Can you see? It's live. It's not just picture. So if you're in Nigeria, $30, you're going to get this. And if you're in any part of this world listening to the sound of my voice and this video, you're going to get it for just $70. So if you're in Nigeria, 30,000 naira. Any part of the world you are, just $70, you can get access to this. So I'm going to drop a link below this video that will take you to where you can just click on this demo, so you can see the demo. You can log into the admin. I'm going to, the admin is username is young, the password is also young, so you can log in and you can do whatever you want to do with this particular script, right? So for Nigeria clients, it's 30,000 naira. For you and any other country client is $70. So I'm also going to drop my WhatsApp number. You can chat me on WhatsApp. And if you purchase this script, you have any issues, you can just chat me on WhatsApp, and I'm just going to help you out. My script has been making a lot of people a lot of millions. Somebody contacted me and said, your script has helped me to make over $40,000. You can imagine that. over $40,000. So I have done it before and I will do it again. So this is a very, very perfect work that you can just take right here and charge your client between $300,000 to $500,000 and boom, the money comes. Once again, my name is Ajayi Adebayo. I am your boy. Thank you so much for all the support. Please subscribe to this channel so that when I drop good videos like this, you will always get notification and then you'll be able to follow everything that I teach. So go ahead and start purchasing this script, because this script is not going to be here forever. In the next 1 month, I can just decide to increase the price to $100K and $300 or $400 as the case may be. So immediately you get across to this, make sure you get this script. So thank you once more and God bless you. And also, if you need any kind of script, you can just let me know. Need any kind of website, we design any kind of website, and we also do training in our office. So if you need any kind of website, let us know. If you need to come for our training, also let us know, and we will just give you all that you need to do.
So when you purchase domain name and hosting, right? So when you purchase the domain name and hosting, you will be sent a username and a password to log into your cPanel, right? So I have logged into my cPanel right away, right here. Log into my cPanel, and when you go to your cPanel, you just look for File Manager. And when you go to File Manager, all you have to do is what? Upload the file that I will be giving to you in this particular training. I'm going to be giving you the file that you are going to use in this particular training, right? So you just upload the files to here to public_html. But you know, public_html is my main domain name. I already have a website in public_html. So this is, so just double click on public_html. So I already have a site right here. So I do not want to do that. So all I need to do is I want to create a subdomain where I'll be doing the job from. So let me go back to here. I'll just search for what subdomain. Just type sub. And you see subdomains will come out here. I'm going to click it, and I'm going to type, I'm going to say video FX. So I'm going to click this here, and it's going to create it for me. Then I'll click on what, create. So it's going to create that subdomain for me, right? It's going to create that subdomain for me. If you're buying from Namecheap, you can easily do this. And if you're buying from other hosting companies, you can also easily do this if they offer you to create a subdomain. But I always advise you to purchase your script from Namecheap, because there are some functionalities that always come with all of these scripts. And if you don't have a very good domain name and hosting, you will not be able to enjoy all of this script, right? You will not be able to enjoy all of this script. So the domain name and the subdomain name has been created. So let me just go back to my homepage, right? So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to opt right to where I have that. So I'm going to click on File Manager, and when I click on File Manager, I'm going to see the subdomain that was just created. It's called Video Forex. So let's search for Video Forex. Oh, this is this. A subdomain, can you see that? So when I click it, it just show me this, right? It just show me. So this is the subdomain name that I created. So I just click on this right here, and then I make sure it is open right here. So you see what I'm going to do now? I'm going to upload this. So I'm just going to upload this right here. I'm going to show files. Don't worry, I'm going to tell you how to get the files. So I have so the files will be here. So you are, when you are getting the file, you're going to see something like this. VD and the database file, these two files, right? So I'm just going to pull these right here, and I'm going to wait for it to upload, right? I'm going to wait for it to upload. So the file is here, and it's just about 86 megabytes, right? It's just about 86 megabytes, and I'm just going to wait for this file to upload. So why uploading this file? I can go right away and create my database, right? I can go right away and create my my database. So let me go right away and create my database, right? So I'll just come here and see data, right? Just come here and see data, and I click on my SQL database. I'm gonna click on my SQL database, and then I will just see video DB, right? So video DB, then I'm gonna click on next. So I'll say video user, right? So video user, then I'm going to generate my password. I can generate, as you see that, click here to generate password as I like. So I'm just going to generate my password. So I like this password. I'm just going to copy this password right here, and I'm going to put this password right here. And then I'm going to say, I have copied this password and use password. So it's very simple, just follow me step by step, right? Follow me step by step. Then you have to now create a user. You see that? So you create a user, then I'm gonna just copy this particular I'm just gonna copy this, and then also come right here and put it here. So I need all of this information to connect to the database, right? I need all of this information to connect to the database. So what I'm gonna do now, just click on all privileges. Make sure you click on all privileges, it's very important. Then I'll click on next step. So you click on all privileges, then you click on next step, and your database is already created. So the next thing I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna upload the SQL file, right? SQL means structure query language. So the SQL file is a database file. You know, you can't have this kind of website without a database. So it's a database driven website. So I'm going to go back to my own page, right? So I'll just click here to go back to my own page, and I'm going to search for PHP my admin. Can you see that? PHP my admin. So this is PHP my admin. So I'm going to click on this. So that's going to open where all my database
a store. PHP admin is used to hold your database information. So that's going to load right away, and I'm going to upload my SQL file, right? So as you can see, you see I have a lot of database here, but the one I'm particular about is what? I think is the video forex, video DB. You see that this is the one I'm interested in right here, video DB. So in your own case, you might not even see anything there. It will just be the first you're going to see because you're doing that for the very first time. But if you also have all that ones, make sure you know what you're doing and just click on that one. So I'm just going to click on import. So I'm going to click on choose file. I'm going to show files, and this is the file. Can you see that? This is the file right here. I'm going to click on this, and I'm going to open it, and I'm going to come here and click on go. Right, so you import it, and you come here and you click on go. Right, so it won't take you less than 1 minute or 1 second to actually get that to be done. So you see that it has populated, right? It has populated. So let me look for the database again. Is video DB. So I'm just going to click on video DB. So I'm going to load all my database tables. So you can see that these are my database table. So I'm interested in wanting here on my database table. I'm interested in my admin, right? I'm interested in my admin. So this is the admin user. So I'm going to open this, the admin user. All right. So when you come to the admin user right here, I'm going to see my username. So this is my username to the database side of this website. My username is Young, so you can double click on it and actually change it. You just type anything you want to put here. I can say Young again. So let me put Young again, Young. So you just press enter. So when you do that, you can change the database. So let me just give you one hack for you to change database password in case you don't know how to change database password. So you see, this is the password and it is encrypted. A lot of people ask me, they don't know how to change encrypted password. So if I want, let's say I want my password to be Young. Right, I have this encryption here. So all I need to do is I'll click on edit right here. I'm going to click on edit right here. So this is the password. You can see that. So here I will now click on this and I will change it to what, MD5. This is a great hack that you can use to hack any database, right? If you don't know the password of any database, this is a great hack for you to hack that database. So you make sure you change this to MD5, then type the password that you want. So let's say I want Young, right? So that is what I want. I'll just click put Young there and I'll click on go. So it's going to now convert that to an encrypted file. Can you see that? So you, this is a great way for you to actually hack any password if you can get into your PHP admin area without knowing the password. So let's see if what we are uploading is still uploading. All right, you see at this percent here, so it's right uploading. So we have our database ready. So let's just wait for this file to upload. All right, so let's just wait for it to get to 100. When you get to 100, you have to wait for it to show the green sign, right? It has to show the green sign. All right, so it has to show this green sign. All right, so when you show that green sign, you have to do, just click on this and just go back. So so let's reload the server. So when we reload the server, we see that particular file here. So we just right click on this file and you see that? Look at the file here, the zip file. So it must be zip like I gave to you, like the way I gave it to you. That's how you just upload it, right? So you have to just right click and click on what, extract. Then you click on extract. So it's extract into video effects. Let me just copy that because I'm going to load that video effects. So I just click on extract. So I'm going to click on close, right? So I'm going to click on reload it. So you see that it has extracted. So I'm going to move it from this VD, you know, it's a folder. I'm going to move from this VD into a videofs.webitmedia.com. So I'm just going to right double click on this. So it's going to open. Fuck. All right, so I'll click on back here.
So let me just reload the server and I'll right click. I'll click on extract. Extract this file. All right, extract everything. Then I'm going to click on close. So I'm going to open this folder right here. All right.